Hello everybody, today in this video we will talk about the Exsanguinist. So, the Exsanguinist is a short story written in 2010 by R.N. Morris. It's edited by Didier and published in France by Pepper Paint. The number of pages turns around 100 and there are 5 main chapters. Quickly, I will introduce you to this author. R.N. Morris, also called Roger Morris in some of his works, is a British writer. He was born in Manchester, in England, in 1960, and is still alive nowadays. He was enrolled at the Cambridge University, where he published his first news in a magazine for teenagers. In 2006, he published his first novel, Taking Comfort. Now, let's talk about The Exsanguinist. The Exsanguinist is a short story. It belongs to the Silas Quinn series, composed of 3 novels and 2 short stories. This is the first component of a series of investigations. Here, we will follow an inspector named Silas Quinn, who is charged of the Special Crimes Unit of Scotland Yard. In this story, the scene takes place in the London of 1914, where a bloodthirsty serial killer rages. The police call him the Exsanguinist because each corpse of his victims have been found without a drop of blood. Our inspector is looking for him and he will try by any ways to catch him before he can kill again. To find his target, he will infiltrate the Potter Club. Inside, he will meet a strange mix of people. A vampire hunter, a doctor who killed one of his patients, a real hunter named Petty, and so forth. A glaucous atmosphere reigns. We can feel it just with the very first sentence of the book, which goes like,
"It's not easy as you think to kill someone."
During all the investigation, we will follow the inspector. We will be reflecting with him on how or why, and when he is in danger, we will be under pressure. More you advance in your reading, more the story becomes interesting. This book has a lot of cool things to support it. One of the biggest advantages is the facility with which you can read it. Why is that easy to be read? It's mainly because the words used are quite simple, and even if you met a word that you don't know, with the entire sentence or the following words, you will be able to understand it without a big difficulty. I mean that an unknown vocabulary won't bother you in the fluidity of your reading. To keep on that way, I want to say that the text is separated in a lot of parts, in addition to the 5 main chapters. It allows you to take regular breaks without cut your reading. A simple vocabulary and a lot of parts don't make necessarily a good book. So, did I enjoy this reading? Yes, I did, and let me explain why. I will repeat myself, but the atmosphere in this London is dark, mysterious and glaucous. The intrigue is classic, simple but efficient. There is a killer and there is a man who wants to catch him. During all this story, you will be analyzing the facts that just happened and you will try to make some hypotheses. The suspense will make you completely focus on what is happening. And until the end, until the final revelation, you won't be able to guess who is the killer, because there is a lot of reversal situations which make you believe that each character present in this story is a possible killer. So, to recap what I said, in this book, you will find exactly what you expect from this kind of detective story. I mean, a suspense, both an intriguing and remarkable main character, and an unexpected ending. I agree that maybe you will read some far-fetched events, but let's face it. If you can guess who the killer is during the first 3 pages, there is no sense to read the rest. For people who don't have a very good English, this book is good. You can read it quickly and without big difficulty. Thank you for watching this video and goodbye.